So after watching 6 seasons of Downton Abbey on Amazon and then a whole movie where we actually get to see a different transition of era where the king and the queen would be arriving in Downton, and how the staff, the rivalry between the royal staff and the Downton staff and all, everything which happened in the movie. And unfortunately, the end was really, really sad because Maggie Smith was one of my most favorite characters. The role which she played, her sarcasm is absolutely the next level. But still, in the new era, the second movie's star cast list still shows her name, so there could be some part that she might have to play. But she, at the end, actually says that Downton is very much safe in Mary's hand, and her legacy would definitely be going forward. So let's quickly react to the 15 seconds quick teaser, and then let's break that down to what we try to understand from the sequel of the first movie. So let's start with the video. This music. Tom's wedding. Okay. So there are a lot of hints actually, and I'm not happy that there's none of the downstairs cars, none of that part. So they're probably heading towards a very different way now. So if you try to break the trailer down now, it just starts with the castle, which is so beautiful, just in the first frame. Then we still get to see there are some maids who are there who would obviously have to be there in order to manage the whole castle, but I would have loved to see some of the other familiar faces. Then the next frame we have Edith and Mary together. They seem to have made their amends since season one. But I kind of like the way the rivalry between them since the season one that the siblings have. But now they seem to have made those amends. Then we have all the four of them. So this could probably Edith and her her fiance or her husband. I don't clearly remember in the movie, and this could clearly be Tom and Mary going for some kind of and those looks like racket. So we are now transitioning from this is some transition definitely towards tennis, and this could just be a scene where they're probably traveling somewhere for a fancy vacation. And now we finally see Tom married again, which was again a hint if you remember in the movie when Violet had kind of told that they could see a spark between him and this could probably his grand wedding could probably be the climax of the movie. And then we just have this family picture where unfortunately there is no Maggie Smith. So this seems to be pretty much of about the second part of the movie. And as we can see, even the kids are grown up. That seems to be Sybil, that is Mary's kid, and then her daughter, and then even Edith's daughter, and all the other people, and finally Bran getting married. And here we see even Lady and Lord Grantham as well. And that is a very small quick teaser which kind of gives you a little hint about how the movie is, but at the same time it doesn't give anything related to the story at all apart from Tom's wedding. So get your first look at the Downton Abbey, a new era, which would be there and only in theaters and Belfast this weekend. So March is definitely going to March 18th the movie would be releasing. I'm not sure worldwide where it would release or where it would be released in on the OTT platforms, but I have been fond of the show now specifically after watching all the seasons because I need something to binge watch. I need some big shows to binge watch, and specifically during this pandemic I have watched so many shows. And whenever you have most of the times, I'm that kind of person who kind of looks for like for example even The Crown or these kind of movies. They are not not very much peculiar with respect to the story, because everything is in history. They cannot really change the story. It is the history. It is the part of the facts which had happened in the past. But the way that they portray these characters, they show these royalties, and the cinematography, everything is amazing. Even this music is very good. Since pandemic, I've watched all the six seasons recently. Like in last week, I finished season 6, and then recently I watched the movie as well. And after becoming even more bigger fan of Maggie Smith, because we've always liked her as Professor McGonagall for all her sassy comments, and she is the same way she was in Harry Potter. Her way of her sarcasm, her point of view, bringing across things which are not even related, and she would make you laugh even in the situations which are very much awkward. And not seeing her in this movie, but she is still a part of the cast. Probably she could be just in a kind of a flashback scene, or there might be some scenes where she could be. So that is it for the quick reaction trailer of the second era, the new era of the Downton Abbey. And the film would be premiering next year. We would have to wait all the way till the month of March to watch this movie. So all in all, if you have not seen any of even the seasons or any of the movies at all, if you are a fan of that era, or if you're a fan of watching those royalties and what could be happening in that time when we are not even born, or where our country was not even a part of, where we were not even having our independence, what was actually happening in their lands, that kind of gives you a point of view of, not obviously you would not relate to that because you are in a bad part and that they are being portrayed as the villains, but in order to watch that from a cinematic point of view, it would definitely be an amazing treat to your eyes, because the cinematography is amazing. Even all the shows, all the six season, I was actually thinking of making a kind of a review video, but in this video I think I will be spoken a lot about what the show is and what it is entirely meant about. All in all, just to sum up in one sentence, the show, all the six seasons which were released earlier, those were in order to portray a royal family, or particularly a part of a county where there is a lord and there is a castle, and how the lords and how their workers, or we could call them as their maids and maidens, how they work from them, and how the titles were given at that time. A lot of part of the war is shown there, like the parts which happen in the back end, like when people are going on war, like from everybody, like at least somebody from each and every family was being chosen to go and fight for the country. So what was happening in the background, that part has kind of shown in one of the season. And later on, how the story unfolds and how the transition would kind of be happening from that era to the new era, and probably they could even release some more future episodes, like what could really have happened at that time, and how they would have transitioned to the new modern world. So that is it for the quick reaction video of the new era, the second prequel of the first movie, which was launched in 2019, and the new movie would be premiering next March. And a quick recap of what entire this show, or what exactly Downton is all about. The show is amazing. The movies are also amazing. If you are watching from a cinematic point of view, it would give you a different vibe, because if you are a fan of that royal era, then it would definitely be giving you an amazing feeling watching through. And if you are looking really to binge watch some show, then currently it is streaming on Amazon. You can binge watch all the six seasons, and then the movie is probably there on Netflix, and then we can wait till March for the second movie to launch. So that is it for the overall quick reaction review. Do let me know what you think about the show and about this entire fandom, we can call that as, because the story is technically not a part of the entire show, because it is everything in its history. They couldn't really make any changes with respect to the story, but the way that they have presented the royal families and how their connections are there with their workers and all the maids, it is a treat to watch indeed. Thank you so much for watching until here. Let me know what you think about the show in the comments and what your thoughts are about the overall film and overall movie. Also, I'm really sad that Maggie Smith's character Violet would not be there in the show based on what exactly happened in the last movie. Thank you so much again for watching until here. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed yet. I'll be meeting you in the next video.